and flip it back into his arm again, and then it'll just maybe into that arm.
Yeah, let me roll it down that way.
That's about it. Well, that is cooking off really nicely this time. I completely filled his arm. So he's, wow, it's hot. It's coming out of there hot. His fingers filled to the brim, and so is this one over here. And you can see why I wanted to put the foam on the outside. See, that arm is flexible. It's so wet with the resin, and the heat will get to the styro spray, make it flex. So it's being held up by the foam on the outside. Okay, we've got to do some brain surgery today. He's got his foam is still a little bit of a layer in there. Looks to be about a quarter inch thick. Good resin buildup on the bottom. And on the top, not on the sides. He hadn't been laying on the side yet as we did his head, so we'll be sure and get this. Yeah, you can see his eye socket down there, and that's just styrofoam. That's got to be covered up. Same thing on the other side. So we'll do one side, then flip him over and get the other. And I have to make a well here to pick up the water and direct it into this hose. Remember, the top of his head connects onto the top roof of the pilot house where we collect rainwater, and then the hose drains it out his body segment down there into the cabin.
Whirled him about in a dizzying circle, up, forward, sideways, down, and then around again. If a man lost his grip, he fell to almost certain death.
He nearly buried that eye socket completely, so that's like an inch of material up there. The rest of this has a half inch. Maybe a little more. It's almost hardened up now, so we roll it over and do the other side.
When appointments were scarce in the peacetime Navy, he went to see an emergency, a period in which heavy weather had struck the ships almost not as a thing as the influence of his first runner, a member of the...
Eye surgery. No, I'll leave that pull off.
So your theory here is you're going to spray the foam through the little teeny tube.
Yeah, you see it going through there.
And it's supposedly going to go up there, come out the other end, and fill the voided area and support the water hose inside this dragon. Is that correct?
No, it doesn't have to support it. It just has to add some more material to it.
Yes.
You are.
I'm so good at this.
Oh. Coming out of his cocoon very nicely, except we have one spot that wasn't strong enough, didn't get any resin in there. So we broke an arm, but it'll be easily mended, I believe. Okay. Yeah, I think this is fixable. And Betsy is putting on the first layer or second layer.
Well, it depends on where you look.
Yeah.
I can't find, I can't, there's either
and
two.
And you fixed the finger.
Yes, I just pinned them on.
Yeah.
It's pinned on.
Okay. And the fracture is obviously complete. It's just actually not bad. Look at that. Oh, you know what?
Look at this.
That color, that's the other glue. We glued this piece of foam on, and the stupid stuff can't get through this.
Okay.
So we've got resin on both sides of this glue interface. All right, the problem with the arm is this color here is this foam, and this stuff does not dissolve like EPS does. And so what happened is we cleared the arm out to here, and then it kind of filters through it, so the acetone runs down into the body cavity, but the resin that I cast the arm with didn't, so I got a nice rigid arm with a really bad joint, so we'll have to join him back at this location, and we should be able to make him just as strong as everywhere else.
Well, got a good sign down.
I stuck my finger in there and regretted it. That's just styrofoam back there. That's not any resin yet. The resin's back behind it. Because there's going to be another joint of glue behind them. Give me a screwdriver. It's one of the metal tools. Anything. Yeah, that'll work. Anything other than flesh.
Hold the camera?
Yeah, see, that's... There we go. Yeah. Yeah, see the same thing. Here's that other foam right there.
Today, had the captain paraded around Tripoli as bright an ass to make the blockade effective. And the theater of operations was more than 3,000...
I think we got it all right. We got pins in there. Put pins in the other one, filled it too. And so tomorrow I'll roll it over and do some more. Well, we're working on the second dragon. This is Dan. He's from Chicago. He's passing through and helping out. And it's the same process we did on the first dragon with a few improvements. One thing we're doing differently is we're using fiberglass cloth on the backside. This is the part that gets, you know, glued up against the side of the boat. And this just keeps it lighter. I didn't have any of the styro spray that I used on the last one, so we went with the cloth here. And but the same thing on this dragon here. Now, we went ahead, and to help me out, I went ahead and cut his hands off. Okay, it's a really cruel thing to do, but there's dragon hands. Lalani did a beautiful job carving these. They'll get glued back on, but it gives us access down through it, because we learned on the last one that the joints that are glued together with the expanding foam, they don't act well with heat or actually they just cook. You know, it's this stuff. It just heat does not bother this. It can take 500 degrees and all it does is char it. And acetone doesn't do much but make it porous, so the fiberglass stuck in it. So we got a glue joint here and another one here. So we're gonna go down through the arm and get both those busted out, and then we can kind of rotomolding from the inside. Now, this whole process is not your normal casting thing. I mean, everybody says, well, not everybody, but the people who cast say, you know, we're gonna make a silicone mold on the outside of this stuff and then cast into that. This thing is the structure and it is the final thing. All we're doing is getting rid of the EPS foam from the inside, then we put our fiberglass on the inside and we just use that as a resin. And you know, it's not what you'd normally see, but it's working great for us and we love it because there's no hundreds of dollars of silicone here or the box that you would need or the external stuff that you would need to do that. There's just two cans of this spray foam, so it's like $20 of an exoskeleton. Just give him a little more rigidity while we work his insides out and put the resin into the inside. And the resin is just this cheap polystyrene fiberglass resin mixed up with microspheres, and that keeps it lighter weight and gives it more bulk. And where we can get fiberglass cloth in this one, like in the head, and maybe down at the bottom, we'll use fiberglass cloth. So it's not a conventional way of making a mold, but damn, it sure is cheap. You're trying to cool your hand off, aren't you?
It works.
Yeah. That's just a piece of greenfield we got on a heat gun. This is heat gun number two. Heat gun number one died. And so, yeah, he's... All right, not that one. This one over here. Oh, yeah, making good progress.
Well, YouTube is. community of people showing ways.
This is a way of doing it, not the, I don't know the way.
Well, there's no such thing as the way.
Well, there's one guy, he said, you know, he was right, you know, making a silicon mold is a great way to go about it, and he's done that with lots of things, but he had a corporation paying to do it.
Right.
There's no corporation here.
And there's only the way for a few years, and then there's another the way.
Yeah,
then
there's another way, right.
So,
I think you're, how far down are you? It's a skewer.
Yeah.
Or kebabs.
Yep. I think that's what's keeping me from going much further.
Holy shit. 11:15.
Yeah. The cone head. Or the cone for the head? Yeah. Yeah, that's going to work.
You think it's bad now, you wait until it starts cooking.
Oh, anyway.
Why?
No, I'm just going to do the dragon nap. Crap pouring out.
I'm looking. So far, so good.
That's all right.
Can add some more to this side. The ears is almost right to the top. Okay, so this is a good shot. This is his paw, and we got one layer of the resin inside, and this is what it looks like. I mean, it is it's just slightly flexible still, but not much. It's really a rigid thing now, and we're going to put a lot more of this filler inside, so he is going to be one fairly stout beast. Flexing is the one thing he won't do very well, but between the pilot house and the roof of the pilot house, we don't anticipate a lot of flex. If there is, we think he's going to crack, and then we'll put an expansion joint in along wherever he cracks and call it good.
Just try and jiggle it and get that air bubble out of there. You cannot injure yourself while here.
My whole attitude in high school was see how fast I can get out.
Oh, I get that thing
out.
Right.
Doing beautiful work. You got one leak right here. Okay.
Fantastic.
You said I'm Miss Pinos, Tanya?
Well, I was hoping it would stop raining and we could mount these up on the boat and show you them where they go, but that did not happen. We've been in a long days of rain, but here they are. We gotta see that there'll be a globe in the mouth for a light, and eyes will have lights behind them, and there's the body and there's the bottom, and up there is what it looks like when it's all done. Now that one's not even set into place. He's just hanging up there on wires right now. I still gotta get a grinder after him and get him fit in nicely, but I like the way they came out very much, and I like the approach. So, you know, you can have your silicone molding. This, to me, is the way to go for one-off big things that you want to do cheap. And I'll tell you what, those are going to really set this boat out. Now, they're going to get fit in and then brought down and painted and then put back up permanently later on.
All right, Jez.